if you want to use WebUSB for your digital art projects today, you need to have two things. First of all, you need Google Chrome because it's the only browser supporting WebUSB yet. The second thing is that you need an Arduino because you can literally control any hardware by using an Arduino. And with the help of this repository, which is maintained by one of the WebUSB spec authors, you can transform the Arduino in a WebUSB compatible device. So let's do this. The code that you load onto the Arduino is called an Arduino sketch. First of all, we load the WebUSB library from the repository. Then we set a default URL, which indicates to the browser on which side our device should be used. And then we do a setup on startup, which is just doing some basic configuration. Then we have a loop, which is called over and over again, and the important bits are that we can receive data from the browser, and we can also send data back to the browser. So when we have this code running on the Arduino and connect the Arduino to the computer, a nice notification pops up, which shows the URL that we just defined. And if we go on this URL, we have some JavaScript to actually use the device. And the first thing we do is we have to call request device to get access to the Arduino. And this has to be happen in the user gesture. And what I'm also doing, I'm setting a filter to only get the Arduino Leonardo that I'm using. When this gets executed, a dialog opens in the browser where we can actually select the Arduino. And if we connect it, then we can actually open a session to the device. Then we select a configuration which we need for the operating system. We claim exclusive access on interface number 2, which means that no other website can use the device. Then we tell the Arduino that we are ready to send data. And when the Arduino is sending data, we're using a transfer in on endpoint number 5. In this case, we are receiving 512 bytes. And when we receive the bytes, we can use a text decoder to convert the bytes into a string. We can also send data back to the Arduino by using a transfer out on endpoint number 4. So now that we know how to turn the Arduino into a WebUSB compatible device, let's use this. For my digital art projects, I'm always using DMX512, which is a standard for professional lighting. Like all the lights you can see in the venues can be controlled using DMX. A way of extending the functionality of the Arduino is by using a shield. So what you can see here in the red is the DMX512 shield I put on the Arduino. I have written a detailed guide on how you can create such a WebUSB DMX512 controller yourself, but as I don't have time to go into detail, I will just show you the result. This is a video of this year's LiveJS performance for JSConf Europe, and besides the visuals in the background, you can see a lot of big squares, and behind every square is a DMX light, and all of them are controlled using the DMX controller. Yeah, so. Yeah, you see the visuals on top, but you can also see all of the lights, and they are synced to the visuals. So whatever is projected on the big screen is also sent directly and live over WebUSB to all these lights. And I controlled, in this case, 135 DMX lights in one universe. Thank you very much. Yeah.